SMS deliverability is the silent killer of mobile marketers. Businesses pay for every text message they attempt to send, not every text that's received. That's because carriers can block messages from your campaign for a number of reasons. There are many factors, such as the SMS API, incorrect numbers, and spam filters that influence whether your SMS messages get delivered promptly. Don't leave your marketing campaigns hanging. Master SMS deliverability with these tips. What does SMS deliverability mean? SMS deliverability is the whole process responsible for placing a text message into your contact inbox. High deliverability rates mean that your messages are successfully reaching their destination. Wireless carriers monitor SMS sent over their networks to prevent spam. Unlike email, where spam filtering is often done in the email client, when a carrier considers an outgoing SMS message spam, they'll block it from ever reaching the recipient's phone. Why do SMS messages fail to deliver? First, spam filters. When you send an SMS campaign, your messages pass through carriers' filters, which are designed to weed out spam. Well, what does a spam text message look like? It comes from identical sender IDs or a weird alphanumeric number. It has similar copy sent to a large audience, and it doesn't include opt-out instructions. So this is where personalizing your text messages and sending broadcasts over a period of time helps out quite a bit. Second up are recipient issues or invalid phone numbers. Phone issues are the most common reason for delivery failures. Basically, you want to make sure you're getting contacts' active cell phone numbers, not a landline. How to improve SMS and MMS deliverability. First, clean your contact list. This means going through your SMS contact list and removing incorrect phone numbers and disengage contacts regularly. You want to ensure your text messages are sent to an interested audience. This will boost your SMS metrics and improve your sender reputation. Second, set up double opt-in to your contact list. Send new SMS contacts a confirmation message after opt-in. It's required by law and can help set expectations for contacts. Plus, it establishes your identity. Double opt-in keeps you compliant and ensures a new contact number is active and that they'll likely engage with your texts, which can in turn increase your SMS delivery rates. Third, just don't send spam. This should be a no-brainer. For each message you send, include opt-out instructions, concise language, and proper capitalization and punctuation to avoid those spam filters. Also, try to include your business's name in the messages and explain why the receiver is getting your texts. Fourth, don't send bulk SMS too fast. Many people begin their SMS marketing efforts with a broadcast to their entire list. When high-volume SMS messages are sent from a number, carriers can flag the broadcast and block your messages. It's no fun. A common myth is that SMS is for mass texting like this, but it's rarely as effective as you might think. If you want to send bulk SMS, make sure to time your messages throughout the day to improve deliverability. Fifth, avoid sending links from domains you don't control. One thing carriers look for when deciding to deliver your SMS is the domain name in your links. If it's mysterious or public, they can block the message and your contact will never see it. Bitly and similar link shortener services can trigger this red flag. So if you do want to send links, the easiest solution is to rely on ManyChat's built-in link shortener, but you can also try using your own domain for shortening links to build a reputation with carriers. Finally, try two-way text with your customers. This is a big one. A two-way SMS live chat with customers is a smart way to improve SMS deliverability. It's also just a good sales tactic. When carriers see recipients in an active conversation with your business, it shows your credibility that you're not a spammer and can improve the chances of getting your messages through in future campaigns. How to measure SMS deliverability. With ManyChat, you can easily find your SMS delivery rates listed right in your SMS message block and flow builder. Message delivery is not the same as messages sent. It measures how many messages were delivered versus the number of messages you sent out in total. So, now that you have a good understanding of how to optimize SMS communication, it's time to start messaging with your contacts. With these tips in hand, you'll get higher SMS delivery rates and show better ROI for your text messaging strategy. Now, if you haven't already, we highly recommend you go through our whole SMS course module before you start. Good luck.